Captain's log supplemental. Although I consider this woman's claim upon my ship to be an empty threat, it has further inspired my determination to expose her for the fraud she is. Come.
You wish to see me, sir?
Yes, Mr. Data. A wise man once said, there is a sucker born every minute.
Barnum, sir. P.T.
I've been examining the dynamics of what used to be called the con game. Quite fascinating. Worthy of your study, Data.
Sir, do you believe Ardra is, to use the vernacular, a con artist?
Yes, I do, Data. And I believe it is our job to out-con the con artist.
Who would you be?
I'm Captain Jean-Luc Picard of the Federation Starship Enterprise.
Keep up the good work.
Who are you?
My, you are forceful, aren't you? Good. I like my men to be forceful, at least at the start. Either. Really, Jean-Luc Picard of the Federation Starship Enterprise, no doubt you have traveled the galaxy, encountered a diverse universe of creatures. Is there no room for the likes of me?
I've encountered many who are more credible to be called the devil than you.
The devil? Now, there's one I haven't heard in a long time.
Carter Bridge, intruder alert. Carter Bridge.
Oh, I've arranged for a bit of privacy. Just the two of us.
This is becoming very tiresome.
Oh, come now, Picard. You know you find me tantalizing. Give in to your desires.
You know, there's nothing about you I find tantalizing. On the contrary, I find you obvious and vulgar.
Easily fixed. I can be your ideal woman, Picard. Prim and proper. And chaste. Until I succumb to your charms. Or would your fantasies turn more toward a professional woman? One perhaps who wears a Starfleet uniform? Perhaps I could even be
someone close at hand, yet unattainable. I can do anything for you, Captain. Anything you could ever imagine.
I could give you a knight that would light fire in your dreams until you die, and you would reject me.
Oh, yes.
You shall regret that.
I think not.
By all rights, your body is already mine. But I want more. I want your heart, your mind, your soul, and I want you to give them to me without resistance, of your own free will. So, do you still wish to pursue this most dangerous game?
I agree to your terms.
Oh, Picard, I will enjoy you morning, noon, and night.
But we must agree to an arbitrator.
Very well. You do not believe my powers are real, do you?
No, I don't.
Then, sir, may I ask you to explain this?
You are out of order.
Or this?
The advocate will refrain from making her opponent disappear.
Or this?
Can you explain it, Picard?
Created this latent fear, which has been passed down through generations. Data. From your own experience of performing Ebenezer Scrooge, you're aware how fear can be a very powerful motivator.
Indeed, sir. In the story,
The spirits used fear to motivate Scrooge to reform his character.
And in the hands of a con artist, fear can be used to motivate obedience, capitulation, the exploitation of innocent people. And that is what I believe has happened here. And I intend to prove that. I need to find a loophole, some way of challenging the validity of this contract.
Sir, the language of the contract seems carefully chosen to avoid any loopholes.
Check it again, Mr. Day.